Welcome. This is your beginner's guide on how to use Later, which is a scheduling tool mostly created for Instagram, but you can add different social media platforms such as Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, TikTok, and let's see what else. Instagram as well. Now, in a free plan, you can have one set of social media only, so one of each, and you are limited to 30 posts per social media account per month, which is calculated as calendar months. So if you used your 30 post on the 15th of July, then you're not going to have any more posts until the 1st of August. And even though if you used all the posts in the 2nd of August, you need to wait until the next month to be able to schedule again. Now, these 30 posts will have available in every single platform that you're using, which means you can create one post each account for a full month. Now, this is the main page where you get to if you log into Later. And I really like this tool to use for Instagram. Now, as you can see, in the top section, you will have your social media accounts, and you can create posts to multiple places. If you tick them, then you will create that post to more than one place. Or if you just click on the profile picture, then you're going to switch to that account. Here, you can change the layout of your calendar, so you can see a monthly view, a weekly view, or a preview, which is very interesting and I really love it. On a preview, you can see the posts that you have on your social media scheduled. As you can see, I don't have scheduled at the moment, but if I would have, I will have a list of posts coming up in the right side. And you can move around these posts, which are scheduled. You can move them around on this phone, so you can see where they are, how they're gonna look like in the end screen when somebody's scrolling on your Instagram. In the left side, this part are your uploaded media that you can use when you're scheduling your content. And this side is your menu. I normally go by the monthly view because that's the easiest way for me. And to create a post, you just need to drag and drop any of these images. Let's say this one. And I'm not sure if it's working on a phone. Okay, so on the phone, you need to tick the image and possibly go to the calendar to schedule, but I don't know why is it not working. On a laptop, you only need to drag and drop the images where you want them to be. Now, I think I placed it here now. Yes, and when you open that image that you put in there, you can add the description. You can edit the image size. You can send a notification or auto publish, which is very rare, because into Instagram normally you can only publish if you get a notification on your phone and then you manually open the application and upload your post. However, in later you can set up an auto publishing system if you have the application on your phone, and then you can schedule in the right side wherever you want on what time, and then you don't need to open the application, it will schedule the post itself. Now on the free plan you can use emojis, you can use saved captions, but you can't use hashtag suggestions. That's only in a paid plan. Also, as you can see, the first comments are not available in the paid plan. You can only add the link to your bio, which is again a very good tool in later, that they create you a link which includes all the links that you have in your post. So you can add a link to every single post, and once somebody click on your bio, on the link in the bio, they will find a page where they can see the post, what they are looking for. They can find the post and then they will find a link that belongs to that post, which I really love. It's really nice and clear and people easily find what they're looking for. I'm not going to create this post, so just need to discard this post. And in the top, it's telling you how many posts you have left for this social media platform. And also you can filter your media. So you can choose to only see the unused media or see what you already used if you want to publish something again, or add labels if you have some, which is again very useful tool. You can upload media from your computer, from your phone. You can even upload multiple media, I think 15 or something like that. I'm not sure how many, but lots of images you can upload from your phone application at once. And you can use Dropbox, is this Dropbox? Yeah, Dropbox. Or you can use Google Drive to upload media to later, which is again a very clever thing. Now in the left side, we are in a calendar now. The second button is the media library. And I even used later when I had to transfer something to my laptop and I didn't have a cable to transfer it through my phone. So I just uploaded the image to later and then I clicked on the image in my media library, and then there's an option to download the image on the computer. Yeah, if you long press the image, you can have an option to download it. So it's a quick way to transfer files between, transfer images between your computer and phone if you don't have a cable with you. You can see all your media in the media library. You can add labels to them, add stars to them. Then you can see conversations. I think this is a paid feature. So on the free platform, on the free account of later, you can't see your conversations. But if you would pay for later, you can see all your messages and comments in here. You have analytics, hopefully. Yes, so we have some analytics here in the free plan, but the proper analytics is, as you can see, only comes on a paid plan, not showing anything at all in here. Only show some data on the post that you created, and that's all. I never checked the analytics tab before though. And again, this is to see the link in bio analytics. Again, you need to have the pro plan. So I think the rest of the button is not really useful for us, but the tool itself is amazing. I really love it. It's easy, it's nice to see everything that you want to do, and you can schedule for as far as you like. I never had an issue on how far I can schedule with this tool. In the phone is a bit difficult to use this. I'm not even able to drag and drop these things in here. So unfortunately, this application, again, something that you can mostly use from a laptop to use it properly. And the stories as well, again, a paid feature. So basically it's just for computer. On the phone you can use the phone application, but that's I didn't like that one, so I prefer to use this on a laptop. I hope you find this tutorial helpful and you will be able to use later now. And I think it's a really useful tool for Instagram. It's really powerful. And I'm going to see you in the next training.